In this tutorial, I will show you all the functions and features of the Scenic Power Planner. So the Scenic Power Planner is accessible through the side menu here in the Power Planner. I will go through it button by button. First, let's start with the top row. So we have the info button here. This will take you to this tutorial video. And the search, with the search, you can find locations, or you can search nearby, like here. You can access your favorite locations, some recent locations that you visited. And you can also go directly to all your locations and find the folders that you created and select one. So for this example, I will search for Apple's headquarters, infinite loop, search, and I select. And now the map centers on that location. And now if you look at the bottom toolbar, there you can add markers. So let's first start. So let's say this is our start location. And now I want to go to, let's say, I'm just going to pick a place on the map. So I'm going to zoom out. And let's say I want to go to San Francisco somewhere. So basically, I just move the marker until the location is on under the crosshair where I want to go. Let's say I want to go here. So here is my destination. So I'm going to press the end button here to place the destination flag. Okay, and now I can press this button to zoom in on the entire route. So you see here on the bottom right, you see it's 68 kilometers, 47 minutes. And this is the normal default routing. Now going back to the third button at the top, the routing button. So here I can select my routing mode. By default, it's balanced without any avoidances. But I can change that to, for example, a short route, and then press recalculate. So now it becomes a little bit different. So you see it's 67 kilometers and 53 minutes. But I can also choose, for example, curvy routing. Now the curvy routings are a little bit different because they add via points to the route in order to force the route to take specific routes. Let's press the generate button here. And as you can see, now it added via points and it's taking a completely different route with a lot more curves in it. Okay. So that's the routing button. Now, let's move on to the bottom toolbar. So we have the start button, which we already used here, and we have a via button. Okay, so now let's see. I can place via points, additional via points to the ones I have on screen. For example, I want to place a via point here. So I put my cross mark here, press the via button, and a via point is added. Now in this case, it's going from 15 to 16 to 17, but then it needs to go to 18, which is up here, so it sends me back immediately. So let's undo that change. And now we have the original route again. Now, by tapping on a via point, we can move it or delete it. As in this case, delete it. Now this doesn't make a much difference because it still wants you to go to the next via point, which was previously 17, now became 16 because we removed one. But we can also move a via point. So when I tap move, it's asking me to move the map to the location where that via point should be moved to. And I tap OK. Now it's 15, and again it's sending me back up and down because it wants me to go to 16 after that. Okay. Now, let's move to the stop button. I can make a stop from this via point by pressing this button. Then it asks me to name the stop. Let's say lunch break in this example. Okay, so now let's suppose there is a restaurant there and I'm going to have a stop. Now, what's the difference between a stop and a via point? Actually, it's not that much. There are two differences. The first one is that you get a notification during navigation when you get close to, in this case, lunch break. For a via point, you don't get those notifications. Also, there are some differences in the detour behavior. So if you deviate from your route, via points could be deleted automatically and stops will never be deleted. More on that in another tutorial video, specifically on the detour behavior. All right, so that's the difference between a stop and a via. Now, as you might have noticed, there are four buttons, two buttons to add a via point and two buttons to add a stop. So let's clear the route and start over. So I'm going to push the clear button and that clears all the points from the map. We start over in San Jose. So I'm just going to place a start flag here. And now I'm going to use the other two buttons here. So I'm going to use via point one, via point two. So this always, even if I go here, it adds the via point at the end. But if in this case I would use the via X button, it will automatically determine that in this case should be going between 1 and in this case 3. While if I use the other button, then it's always going to be placed in the end, the via point. And the same goes for the stop. Now there are some scenarios where, for example, let's place a via point here. And now I want to go place a via point here. The automatic, let's push the button here. So automatically it places it between 1 and 3. But maybe in this case, I want to visit this location where the crosshair is after 2, before 3. So in that case, I can manually choose that. So in this case, I tap and hold the via X button. And now it's asking me to tap the marker before the new via. So in this case, I want to tap marker 2. And now this becomes via 3. So this is a way to override the automatic placement. It's a smart algorithm that more or less determines where it thinks that you want to place the via point, but sometimes that algorithm doesn't work and you want to override it. In that case, you tap and hold the via X button or the stop X button. All right, so let's go to only the start point here. And let's go to the round trip on the top toolbar, excuse me. So here you can generate a round trip that starts where I position the start flag. Basically, you give a distance. So in this case, I want to have one of around, it's never going to be exact, but around 150 kilometers in the south direction. And I want it to be, let's leave it on curvy, and I don't want to go on unpaved roads, so I want to avoid those. And I choose generate trip, and then Scenic calculates a round trip that is a bit curvy, goes more or less to the south, and is about 150 kilometers. Okay, so that's the round trip. All right, now let's go to the more button on the bottom left. So on the more button, there are a few additional functionalities. So here I have a round trip, but maybe I don't want to start there, but at via point 11. Let's say I received this round trip from somebody else who lives where the start flag is now, but you don't live there, so you want to start somewhere else. So you want to shift the start point of the round trip. So let's do that. So now it asks me, okay, so you don't want to start and finish flag. where do you want to start? So in this case, let's say I want to start at via point 7. Okay, so now Scenic recalculates the entire route. So now the start and finish flag are at where via point 7 was, and all the via points have been renumbered, but the route is still the same. You just, the start and end point is somewhere else. But now let's say you don't want to travel in this direction, but you want to travel in the other direction. So there is a reverse function here. Now you get a warning because reversing a route, like it says, can result in strange loops and other routing errors. This is because, let's suppose you go on a highway and the via point is on the right side of the highway going north. And now when you reverse the route, you need to go south. So basically the via point needs to be on the other side of the highway. Now Scenic isn't smart enough to know that. So it will still try to send you north up the highway to be able to reach that via point. So you need to check very well what happens. So one way to check this is to check the distance, for example. If you see here, so this is before I reversed, the distance is 151 kilometers. Now, let I redo that, the reversing, or tap the redo button, and now it's 159 kilometers. So somewhere, probably, a strange loop was added. So let's zoom in a little bit to see if we can find it. Okay, so here everything looks fine. No strange loops, no strange loops. Here is maybe the strange loop. Yes. So what we can do here in this case is move the via point a little bit. So let's move it here. And the strange loop is gone. Okay, there should be more because the distance is still a bit long. Let's see here. This all looks fine, 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 fine. Here something strange is going on. So just let's delete this via point. See what happens. No, that's not correct because now it's taking a completely different route. So let's place the via point here. Okay, that's already a lot better. Okay, so there are a couple of other things. So maybe this is an additional loop that was added because you reversed the route. And here is a big one. This is exactly what I mentioned before. So this via point 10 is on the wrong side of the highway in this case because we reversed the route, so we need to change that to this side. Hop, and all of a sudden my distance has become what the distance was. All right, so this is reversing the route. Let's see what else we have under the more button. So we have here the remove all vias button. Let's just do that, see what happens. Okay, that leaves me with a start and an end flag at the same position, so I don't have a route anymore. Okay, let's press the undo button. See what else we have. So I can convert all stops to vias. Well, there is no stop in this case, so they are all vias now. And I also can convert all vias to stops. Okay, so now I have all stops. Then one last function to display is the batch delete button. So with this button I can delete multiple via points at once. So let's say I want to delete from via point 9 or stop 9 in this case to via point 21. So now these have been deleted and the route becomes a little bit shorter, as you can see. Let's press the undo button to see the difference. So this is the batch delete function. And now one other function I want to show you is this arrow up you see here. If you press that, you get the route timeline. So you see at what time, not what time, but duration wise, how many minutes into the route and how many kilometers or miles into the route you will reach the stops. And also you can reorder the stops here. For example, that, or you can delete stops here and then the route automatically changes. And that's in a nutshell the Power Planner. So now I can save the route, I can name the route test route for tutorial. Press save. And now my route is in the routes. And I placed it under the test routes folder. Let's put the newest on top. And there it is. Test route for tutorial. It's generating the thumbnail now. And if I select it, then here it is. You can also see the elevations here and that kind of stuff. But I will go into that in more detail in another video. So that's the Power Planner for you.